Hey family, this is Pastor Mark Moore Jr., the senior pastor of Spirit and Truth Church, and I wanted to take a moment just to give a bit of a memory test to our members and our online family, just to see how well you remember. Do you remember 4 weeks ago when we had our church vision night and I expressed that the number one goal and objective 2024 was to acquire our Atlanta campus with a sanctuary that seats at least 400, has adequate parking, space for youth and outreach ministry. Do you remember that?
I'm believing that by April 28th, we will have our Atlanta campus. Right? And wherever we're going, it's going to take resources to get things where they need to go, do what we need to do. And I'm believing that we're going to raise $200,000 in a day. I'm believing this year we're going to acquire the Atlanta campus. It will have at least 400 seats. It will have ample parking, and it will have space for training and youth ministry. Somebody say, yes, Lord.
Okay, what about, let's go back 3 weeks ago when in faith we purchased all of the remaining backline. That's the organ and the keyboard and the in-ear monitor systems and the instruments that we needed for an Atlanta campus that we did not have at the time, nor did we have any idea on where it was, but our faith demanded that we make a move. Do you remember that 3 weeks ago? It's been coming up. We made a faith move this past week, Pastor. We made the decision to buy all of the instruments. Now, we've owned the sound equipment for months. We have equipment in storage, Natasha, that we can't even use in the school because it's line arrays, speakers, and things that have to be installed in a permanent facility. And so we've been in this faith space and renting instruments every week and organs and drums and whatnot. And we made the faith statement this week and purchased every cable, every cord. We bought a new Hammond organ. Y'all ain't saying nothing. We bought new drums. We got everything we need for the Atlanta campus, even though we don't have an Atlanta campus yet. Okay. What about 2 weeks ago when the Lord told us to call a clarity consecration involving a solemn assembly where we were doing nothing but praying and fasting, believing that God would open the door because the heart of the king is in the hand of the Lord. Do you remember that 2 weeks ago?
The Lord told me to call what we're going to call a clarity consecration. So I want you to hear me. This week, Monday through Friday, we're going on a clarity consecration.
Okay, what about 1 week ago on the Friday night victory service when I shared with you that God had said that we did not waste a week of consecration? Do you remember that 1 week ago?
Tell somebody, prophesy to them and say, neighbor, you didn't waste your consecration. No, you got the wrong neighbor. Tell somebody you didn't waste your consecration. And if you, hallelujah, if you're really about it like you say you are, tell that person that you just talked to, tell them one more time, say, neighbor, I don't have to wait till I see it. I believe it's already done.
What about, okay, let me, one more. What about this past Sunday when we stood in McNair High School, the cafetorium, and declared that there's a leak in this old building and our church has got to move, not knowing that we wouldn't be able to be there much longer? Do you remember that?
We gotta get all our praise out in this school, though. Because I'm just trying to tell you, we're not going to be in this school much longer. We're not going to be here much longer. Woo. So long, bye-bye. Let the bell ring. That's fine. We ain't gonna be here much longer.
Okay, you probably do, but you're cheating because that's so recent. Let's go back a little bit further. Do you remember November of 2023 when we shared that God had given us an unction to believe for a South Campus? Do you remember that? Do you remember that in just 2 weeks' time, we raised over $100,000 and renovated and furnished our South Campus 100% debt-free? Do you remember that after moving in on December 31st, fulfilling the word that God gave us, that we were going to do it before the end of the year? Do you remember that in January, by the time the end of the month came, we had to go to two services to accommodate the growth? You remember that? Well, okay, you guys are passing this really easy. Let's go back a little bit further. Let's go way back. Do you remember in Deuteronomy chapter number 6, where the Lord declared that he would give us houses that we did not build, wells that we did not dig, and vineyards that we did not plant? Do you remember In Amos chapter 9, when the word declared that he was going to make it happen so fast, our head would swim, one blessing on the heel of another. It's important that we take this memory test. I'm asking you these questions for a reason, because one of the weapons against the favored is the trap called forgetfulness. I do not want our church, those that are members of our Atlanta locations or even our cyber members, I don't want us to be the kind of people that become forgetful and fail to realize the weight and the magnitude of what God has already done. Because if we fail to remember what God has done, then we won't properly celebrate what God is doing. And so this whole quiz, you guys did pretty well, but the whole quiz is really to lead us to this moment where I share with you that all of this is really gauging our response. Do we know how to celebrate what God is doing? Do we know how to praise him for what he's about to do? Because if we know how to praise him, I want you to show me, what would you do? What will you do? What are you getting ready to do right now when I share with you that even though our church is less than 1 year old, we are now the proud owners of a 5-acre, 400-seat sanctuary with 3 buildings, our Atlanta campus. We're not renting. We're not borrowing. Spirit and Truth family, I want to tell you, welcome home. See what the Lord has done.